रेडियो खांची 90.4 FM, हम सब का रेडियो। आई डॉक्टर रूपा वर्मा, फैकल्टी फ्रॉम MSc बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, रांची यूनिवर्सिटी, रांची। इन माई प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैड डिस्कस अबाउट जनरल इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल फर्मेंटेशन एंड मीडिया ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल फर्मेंटेशन। दिस लेक्चर विल बी यूजफुल फॉर ऑल PG 4th semester बायोटेक्नोलॉजी स्टूडेंट्स। In my today's lecture, I will discuss history and introduction of fermentation, types of fermentation, first on the basis of fermentation technique, and second type of fermentation on the basis of culture. Fermentation is the process of growing microorganism in a nutrient media by maintaining physicochemical conditions and thereby converting feed into desired end product. Fermentation technology is the use of organisms to produce food, pharmaceuticals and alcoholic beverages on a large scale industrial basis. Fermentation has been widely used for the production of wide variety of substances that are highly beneficial to individuals and industry. Over the years, fermentation techniques have gained immense importance due to their economic and environmental advantages. You know, traditional fermentation technology is more than 3000 year old in India. The fermentation technology employed a variety of processes and was put to a large number of uses. The basic principle involved in the industrial fermentation technology is that organisms are grown under suitable conditions by providing raw materials meeting all the necessary requirements such as carbon, nitrogen, salt, trace elements and vitamins. The end product formed as a result of their metabolism during their lifespan are released into the media, which are extracted for use by human being and that have a high commercial value. Fermentation is a natural process. People applied fermentation to make products such as wine, cheese, and beer long before the biochemical process was understood. In the 1850s and 1860s, Louis Pasteur became the first germologist. Germologist means the one who expert in the field of fermentation. The first solid evidence of the living nature of yeast appeared between 1837 and 1838, when three publications appeared by C. Cagniard, D. Latour, D. Schwann and F. Kutjing, each of whom independently concluded as a result of microscopic investigation that yeast was a living organism that reproduced by budding. In 1860s, in a series of classic investigations, proved conclusively that fermentation was initiated by living organism. In 1857, Pasteur showed that lactic acid fermentation is caused by living organisms. In 1860, he demonstrated that bacteria caused souring in milk, a process formerly thought to be merely a chemical change, and his work in identifying the role of microorganisms in food spoilage led to the process of pasteurization. In 1877, working to improve the French brewing industry, Pasteur published his famous paper on fermentation. He defined fermentation as life without air, but correctly showed specific types of microorganisms cause specific types of fermentations and specific end products. In 1877, the era of modern medical bacteriology began when Koch and Pasteur showed that the anthrax bacillus caused the infectious disease anthrax. We have discussed about the historical background of fermentation. Now come to the types of fermentation. In broad term, we can say that the fermentation may be classified on the basis of fermentation techniques and it may be classified on the basis of culture. On the basis of fermentation technique, which may divide into two, first one is surface or solid state fermentation, second is submerged fermentation. Types on the basis of culture, there may include, first one is batch fermentation, second is continuous fermentation, third is feed batch fermentation. Now first come to the surface or solid state fermentation. In solid state fermentation, that may also called as SSF, has been defined as the fermentation process occurring in the absence or near absence of free water. Solid state fermentation, that is SSF, is another method used for the production of enzymes, which involves the cultivation of microorganisms on a solid substrate, such as grains, rice, and wheat bran. SSF employs natural raw materials as carbon source, such as barley, wheat, bran, sugarcane, various oil cakes like palm, kernel cake, soybean cake, groundnut oil cake, fruit pulp, sawdust seeds, and coffee husk and coffee pulp, tea waste, and spent brewing. There are some examples of solid state fermentation product, that is mushroom product, where substrate used are straw and manure, microorganism involved Agaricus bisporus. In case of soya sauce, as a substrate, soya beans and wheat generally used, and microorganism used here Aspergillus oryzae. In cheese, substrate used is milk curd, and a microorganism uses Penicillium species, that is Penicillium roqueforti. For production of organic acid, the substrate used are cane sugar, molasses, and microorganism involved Aspergillus niger. There are four major factors that is very important in SSF processes. First one is selection of microorganism. Second one is substrate, third one is process optimization, and fourth one is product isolation and purification. Now come to the selection of microorganism. This is one of the key factors for improved yield of the product. Bacteria, yeast, filamentous fungi can be used. Filamentous fungi has shown better result growing in the solid substrate fermentation. The second factor is substrate. Substrate also play important role in determining the growth of microorganism, thereby increasing the product yield. Substrate is chosen such a way that it should provide physical support as well as nutrient to the growing culture. Substrate may be of two types. One is specific substrate, which requires suitable value additions or disposal. The second is for producing a specific product from a suitable substrate. Process optimization is also a very important portion or factor, which include the optimization of physicochemical and biochemical parameters like size, initial moisture, pH and pretreatment of the substrate, relative humidity, temperature of incubation, agitation and aeration, age and size of the inoculum. Nutrient supplementation is very important, such as nitrogen, phosphorus and trace element supplementation of additional carbon sources and inducers. And extraction of product and its purification is also very important. There may be some problems in SSF also, which are heat transfer. One of the main difficulties is to control the temperature during the fermentation process in SSF fermentation technology. Heat is generated during the metabolic activities of microorganisms. Since the substrate used has low thermal conductivity, heat removal will be slow. When the heat generated goes beyond certain level, which will result in product denaturation and will affect growth of microbe, ultimately ending up in reduction in yield and quality of the product. Now come to the application part of the SSF. SSF is being employed in various fields ranging from pharmacology to bioremediation, covering various aspects of biodiversity conservation. You may say it is useful in the production of industrial enzymes. Almost all the known microbial enzymes can be produced under SSF system. Enzymes of industrial importance like proteases, cellulases, lignases, xylanases, pectinases, amylases, glucoamylases, phenolic acid, esterases, microbial rennets, etc. Second application is the production of biopesticides. You know, the infamous Bacillus thuringiensis, that is BT's protein, can be produced in large scale in order to address the issues of pest attacks, yield damage. Another application is the production of renewable energies. Renewable energies referring to the biogas productions by utilizing the biomass from plant and animal sources when subjected to anaerobic fermentation by the microbial flora results in generation of biogas which can be effectively utilized for running gas turbines and fuel cells. SSF uses in bioleaching also. The recovery of metals from low-grade black shale ore was attempted by employing microbial samples using different organic waste or substrate. Maximum recovery of metals such as copper, cobalt, zinc and other metals is possible by continuous SSF. Here, media components containing glucose and molasses etc. used as substrate. SSF also used in bioremediation. The discovery that certain microorganisms living within our environment can actually degrade various toxic components like hydrocarbons, oil spillage has made possible the utilization of biological methods for treatment of these toxicants. A biosurfactant accelerates the process of degradation of pollutant composites. A biosurfactant produced through fermentation subjected for bioremediation yields better result when compared to chemical remediations. Now, second classification on the basis of its technique is submerged fermentation. In the submerged process, the substrate used for fermentation is always in liquid state, which contains the nutrients needed for growth. The fermenter, which contains the substrate, is operated continuously and the product biomass is continuously harvested from the fermenter by using different techniques. Then the product is filtered or centrifuged and then dried. Submerged fermentation is a method of manufacturing biomolecules in which enzymes and other reactive compounds are submerged in a liquid such as alcohol, oil or nutrient broth. The process is used for a variety of purposes like industrial manufacturing. Other applications are submerged fermentation or liquid fermentation utilizes free-flowing liquid substrate such as molasses and broth. The bioactive compounds are secreted into the fermentation broth. The substrates are utilized quite rapidly, hence need to be constantly replaced or supplemented with nutrients. This fermentation technique is best suited for microorganisms such as bacteria that require high moisture. An additional advantage of this technique is that purification of product is easier. This technique is primarily used in the extraction of secondary metabolites that need to be used in liquid form. We may compare the solid state fermentations with submerged fermentation. Solid state fermentation utilizes solid substrate like bran and paper pulp, whereas submerged fermentation utilizes free-flowing liquid substrates such as molasses and broths. In SSF, substrates are utilized very slowly, need not to be replaced. But in submerged fermentation, that is SMF, where substrates are utilized quite rapidly, need to be replaced constantly. SSF fermentation best suited for fungi that require less moisture content. But SMF, that is submerged fermentation, best suited for bacteria that require high moisture content. SSF culture system involves three phases, solid, liquid and gaseous. Where SMF involves two phases, liquid and gaseous phases. SSF system may or may not involve agitation, but SMF system agitation is essential. So we may classify the basis of culture, which include batch fermentation, continuous fermentation and fed batch fermentation. So first one is batch fermentation. Nutrients are added in the fermentation for the single time only and growth continues until the particular nutrients are exhausted. In the batch process, when the microorganism is added into a medium, which supports its growth, the culture passes through a number of stages known as growth curve. A typical growth curve consists of following stages. First one is lag phase. Second one is acceleration phase. Third one is log or exponential phase. Fourth one is deceleration phase. Fifth one is stationary phase. And sixth one is death phase. In lag phase, immediately after inoculation, there is no increase in the number of the microbial cells for some time, and this period is called lag phase. In this phase, the organism adjusts to a new environment in which it is inoculated into. The second is acceleration phase. The period when the cells just start increasing in number is known as acceleration phase. In log phase, there is a time period when the cell numbers steadily increase. In deceleration phase, the duration when the steady growth declines. The stationary phase, the period where there is no change in the microbial cell number, is the stationary phase. This phase is attained due to depletion of carbon sources or accumulation of the end products. The death phase is the period in which the cell numbers decrease steadily, is the death phase. This is due to death of the cells because of the depletion of energy resources. Depending upon the product required, the different phases of the cell growth are maintained. For microbial mass, the log phase is preferred. For production of secondary metabolites, like antibiotics, the stationary phase is preferred. Now come to the continuous fermentation. The growth rate and physiological conditions of microorganism can be maintained by using a process of continuous culture. In this, the product are removed continuously along the cells and the same is replenished with the cell girth and addition of fresh culture media. This results in a steady or constant volume of the contents of the fermenter. This type of fermentation is used for the production of single cell protein, antibiotic and organic solvents. In fed batch fermentation, freshly prepared culture media is added at regular intervals without removing the culture fluid. This increases the volume of the fermentation culture. This type of fermentation is used for production of proteins from recombinant microorganisms. The total amount of the biomass in the vessel increases, but biomass concentration is maintained constantly. So that's all about the fermentation types. You should go through the books also and my written lecture also. Thank you to all students and listeners. Next lecture will be on biotransformation.